Hello everyone. I take great pleasure in wishing all of you, each and every one of you, a very happy 75th birthday at Bajaj Auto. It has indeed been a glorious 75 years. It's a historic moment. And I want to thank from the bottom of my heart each and every person that made this possible. Not just those of us who are still around, but equally those who have contributed in the past and laid the foundation upon which we continue to build. I want to thank not only those in Bajaj Auto, but also those outside of it. Right down to the last contract workman at our smallest supplier, and to the last salesman and the last mechanic at our dealership, sub-dealerships, and at our distributors across the world. I want to thank everyone, including our partners KTM, who have helped us become a better version of ourselves. And I also want to thank those that we may not know. People who by some act, some thought, some prayer somewhere may have blessed us. Because we believe that we live in an interconnected world where we are all dependent on each other. And very often, in the words of Mr. Narayan Murthy, we do eat fruits of trees that we do not plant. So it is with that sense of gratitude that we must thank everyone. I remember being told once that the great Soichiro Honda had said, "It is not the manufacturer that shapes the market. It is the customer that shapes the market." So most of all, we must thank our customers, because although it may seem cliched, the simple truth is, if they did not favor us, you and I would not be here. So on this day, we express a deep sense of gratitude to all our customers of the last 75 years across over 70 countries across the world. Friends, our achievements, I would say in all modesty, have been many in the last 75 years. I do not intend to elaborate on that. Suffice to say that we have all had the privilege, absolute privilege, of being part of a journey of a company that has created new segments across the world with path-breaking products and technology. What more can one ask for in terms of a career experience? But I still think that that is our second greatest achievement, i.e. consistent high performance for 75 years in a row. I cannot think of too many global companies that can lay claim to that. Nevertheless, I would like to say that that is the second most important achievement that we can be proud of. The single most important one is this: to have conducted our business with a sense of integrity in the widest sense of the word. And for this, we have to thank our chairman, Shri Rahul Bajaj, because he has always said to us that at the end of the day, it is less important if you are the tallest person in the room. What is much more important is that irrespective of how tall you are standing in that room with your head held high. And this reputation for integrity, I think, is our greatest achievement, our greatest wealth, our greatest possession. And may it always be so. Friends, speaking of being in a room with one's head held high, I'm reminded of what Helmut Schmidt said when he said that the biggest room in the world is the room for improvement. Improvement is a never-ending process. That is the meaning of progress. That is the meaning of evolution. And that is what gets us out of bed every morning, because I don't think any of us come to work at Bajaj Auto only to maintain the status quo. As Yamaguchi-san has taught us, every day we come intent upon making some improvement so that today is better than yesterday. And all improvement must be customer-centric, obviously. But I would hasten to add, not customer-centric in an emotional sense, but customer-centric in a strategic sense. And by that, what I mean is that we must continue to offer customers not only what is relevant to them, what is meaningful to them, but also that which our competition cannot offer, which is exactly what our marketing guru Jack Trout taught us. That, in one word, is called differentiation. And differentiation, as you all know very well, is the perpetual mantra of business at Bajaj Auto. So as we move forward from the last 75 years to the next 25, 50 or 75 years, let us ask ourselves what improvement, what progress, what evolution we would like to see in our business, i.e., how will we continue to differentiate? I would like to believe that we will do so by bringing greater and greater differentiation to bear upon the business of commuter motorcycles. Unfortunately, it has been said that in the marketplace, every commuter motorcycle looks like every other commuter motorcycle. Friends, we have to change this. This is not called a brand. This is called a commodity. As some of you are aware, we are already working in that direction. And hopefully, in the year 2021, we will bring a great deal of differentiation to bear upon the commuter motorcycle segment. We would like to do the same to maintain our dominant position, our leadership in the sport motorcycle segment with brands like Pulsar, Avenger, Dominar, KTM, Husqvarna. Not only in volume terms, not only in market share terms are we the leader, but we are the company that is credited with having changed the course of motorcycling in India for sure, with the launch of Pulsar in 2001, and also in many markets across the world. From the Boxer in Africa, through the Pulsar in most parts of the world, to KTM, we have had the privilege of creating these great brands over the last 20, 25 years. And we must continue to do that into the future. In the intra-city segment of three-wheelers and quadricycles, both passenger and cargo, where we continue to be for the longest time a world leader, we really owe it to ourselves to do even more. Not only in terms of product, but in terms of every aspect of the business. And thereby to bring greater and greater differentiation to bear upon the marketplace. And finally, folks, in export markets, what a wonderful run we have all had. I personally never imagined a day would come when Bajaj Auto would export over 2 million units in a single year. And to have done over 200,000 vehicles a month, month after month of late, in perhaps the most difficult of times, this is certainly no mean achievement. But while we have done very well, we are aware that there are many advanced markets where we are yet to make our mark in a significant manner. There are many large markets where we are still not present. So these are the opportunities that lie before us. And again, if we approach these with a sense of differentiation, we are bound to be rewarded. So friends, it is with this sense of entrepreneurship across all businesses that we must move forward. because entrepreneurship was very dear to our founder, Sri Kamal Nayan Bajaj. He was not a man who was obsessed with quantity, with size, with scale. But he was a man who was passionate about doing something new, about creating stuff, about being an entrepreneur. And I think, and I would like to believe, that we will carry that spirit of our founder with us to work every day. And how shall we do all this? Friends, I would like to suggest that we will do it in the same manner that we have done it over the last 75 years. We will do it by continuing to build the best two-wheeler R&D in the world, period. The reason people want to partner us is, of course, due to competitive manufacturing, global distribution, but neither of those would be possible if we did not have a world-class R&D in the first place. And to me, above all, a world-class R&D is this. It is a place where the best engineers who want to work in the automotive field find their place. So if we can be that aspirational place of work for such kids, then I would say that our R&D has truly arrived. Friends, we are already the benchmark for world-class quality and cost in the eyes of many. Otherwise, we would not have the partnerships that we have. We would not be exporting the numbers that we do. Our competitive manufacturing rests on TPM and is empowered and enabled by world-class IT. And we must continue to improve upon that every single day. Finally, friends, I would like to say that in terms of our management practices, our management functions, including HR, including finance, I think the key word there is simplicity. Because Peter Drucker said, a lot of what we call management is actually doing things that make it difficult for people to do their jobs. So I think in all our management processes, we must continue to improve so that we make it easier and easier by partnering the businesses, by partnering the R&D, by partnering the operations in such fashion that it becomes easier for them to do their jobs. Friends, finally, I would like to close with one of the very profound thoughts of Shri Jamnalal Bajaj. He said, Kathni Karni Eksi. Kathni Karni Eksi means, as is the talk, so should be the walk. We have to walk the talk. And friends, beyond all financial metrics and other metrics associated with the business, I think when all of us retire, when our time comes to an end, I think nothing would give us greater satisfaction than knowing that we leave this world, this industry, this market, this company in a better state than when we found it. At least for me personally, that would give me the greatest sense of satisfaction. And towards that objective, I would like to urge all of you in Bajaj Auto and those outside of it but associated with it, let us do our very best and employ all the resources at our command to create a new beginning for our company and in a way for our country with electric vehicles. Not only because the world needs them, not only because we need a sustainable business, not only because it is logical, because such scooters, motorcycles, three-wheelers and quadricycles are eminently electrifiable, but because it puts us squarely at the starting line. You know, we were a little late to the motorcycle party. We were a little late to the exports party. We have been fortunate that we could make up for lost time. we may not have the same luck a second time around. So let us all single-mindedly work towards creating such a bright new future, not only for ourselves, but more importantly for our children. A future that is sustainable. And a future where across the world, our country, our people, our engineers and our managers are acknowledged and acclaimed for having made a new beginning which makes a significant impact upon the world that we live in. With these words, I would like to once again thank all of you from the bottom of my heart. I congratulate you all once again and send you my best wishes. Thank you.